मायसेल्फ दर्शना भीमराव मोरे, असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ फ्रूट सायन्स, केकेवा कॉलेज ऑफ हॉर्टिकल्चर, नासिक. टुडे आय एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट हार्मफुल अँड बेनिफिशियल इफेक्ट ऑफ वीड्स रिगार्डिंग द कोर्स ऑफ वीड मॅनेजमेंट इन हॉर्टिकल्चरल क्रॉप्स. सो द फर्स्ट वीड मीन्स अ अनवॉन्टेड प्लांट्स ऑर देर इज अ नो इकॉनॉमिक व्हॅल्यू. अ प्लांट कन्सिडर्ड undesirable, unattractive or troublesome, especially one that grows where it is not wanted and often grows or spread fast or takes the place of desired plants. A plant that is not value where it is growing and is usually of vigorous growth. So the weed, there are about 30,000 species around the world. Which is about 18,000 causes serious losses in agriculture production. So the weed is the term coined by Jethro Tull in the book of Horse Hoeing Husbandry. Some of the characteristics of weed. The weed are also like other plants but have a special characteristics that it tends to put them in a category of unwanted plants. So the weed causes harmful effect on agricultural crops, then animal and human health. So that's why it is classified as a weed. Most of the weeds, especially annual, produce enormous quantity of seeds. For example, wild oats, that is Avena fatua, produces 250 seeds per plant, whereas the wild Amaranthus viridis, produces nearly 11 billion of seeds. It has been observed that among 61 perennial weeds, that average seed production capacity was 26,500 per plants. So the weeds having ability to produce a number of seed from a single plants, then the weeds have the capacity to withstand adverse condition in the field because they can modify their seed production and growth according to the availability of moisture and temperature. So the weed having capacity to can be withstand in any adverse climatic conditions, it can be also produces number of seeds and vigorous growth. They can germinate under the adverse soil moisture condition, have short period for of a plant growth, generally grows faster rate and produces seed earlier than most of the crops growing in association. So the weeds having a different life cycle. For example, some weeds are biennial, some are annual, and some are perennials. So the some weeds having short life cycle, that means the fast growing habit and produces a number of seeds within a short periods. So the weed seed remain viable for a longer period without causing their viability. For example, creeping thistle for the 20 years and field bean weed Convolvulus arabensis for about 50 years. Then weed seed have a tremendous capacity to disperse from one place to another through the wind, water, animal, including man. Many of times the weed seed mimic with the crop seeds due to their size and get transported from one place to another along with them. So the weeds having characteristic of mimic weeds, that means the same morphological structure of agricultural crops. For example, wild oat in or the wild rice in rice. So the, at the time of harvesting, the mimic weeds easily mix with the agricultural crops and can be transported from one place to another. And second thing is the seed structure of weed is different. For example, some weed seeds are parachute like structure, wing like structure, and comus like structure. So that can be transmitted through wind. Some of the harmful effects of weed. So the first harmful effect of weed is the competition for mineral nutrients and water. So the weed are vigorous in growth habit than the crops. The weed consumes large amount of nutrients that cause heavy losses in the yield. near up about an average removal of nutrient by the weeds in a kharif crops, 46.6 kg of nitrogen per hectare, 12.8 kg phosphorus per hectare, and 73.3 kg per hectare. So the main nutrient or the essential nutrient NPK required for the agricultural plant growth, that nutrients can easily or the very fastly absorb uptake by the weed plants. So the losses causes in agricultural produce. Then weed also compete for the water. So the for the production or the for producing equal amount of dry matter, weeds general transpire more of water than most of the crops. It has been also reported that the wild mustard transpire about 4 times of more water than the wood crops. So the result is that the poor grain, then oil and seed production of crops. Then second, reduction in yield. Weed compete with crop for the space, nutrients, then water, soil moisture, solar energy, etc. So the intensity of weed competition depends upon the type of weed species, severity of weed infestation, duration of weed infestation, competing ability of crop plants, and climatic condition which affect the weed and the crop growth. So the types of the species of weed also responsible for the reduction of crop yield. Reduction in crop yield has also direct correlation with weed competition. Generally, an increase in 1 kilogram of weed growth corresponds to reduction in 1 kilogram of crop growth. Then, competition for space. Weed compete for the space both in rhizosphere and atmosphere. In the presence of weed in a crop and also have a limited space to develop their shoots and reduce the photosynthesis. Then competition for solar energy. About 99% of dry matter is in a plants is made up of organic matter that is dependent upon solar energy. When the plants are mutually shaded, their production potential is generally or the greatly reduced, even though water and other nutrients are available to them in abundance. Then increase in cost of insect and diseases control. Weeds give the shelter to the for the various insect pests or the serve as an alternate host. Weed seeds around paddy burns harbor the gall fly. Then wild oat harbor stem rust of wheat, oat and barley. Weeds serve as a host in off season and then migrate to the crops and damage the crops. Then next is reduction in cost, increase in cost of cultivation. Due to the high infestation of weed, increasing cost of cultivation like insecticide, pesticide and herbicides, then also the labor cost is also increases. When the land is infested with weeds, the tillage operation is done to control the weeds, and this cost of tillage increases till the further, and more labor are also required to be employed for the weeding and hoeing. Then next is the reduction in land value. Agricultural lands which are heavily infested with perennial weeds like kuns, nutgrass, hariyali, bear, vedi babu reduces the sale value of land, because the cultivation of different crops on such a land is only it not possible because these are the perennial weeds. Such a land only possible after a spreading heavy expenditure to eliminate these weeds either with machinery or labor. Then less efficient use of land. Due to the presence of perennial weeds, such land may not be cultivated for the crop production. Because the perennial weeds, we cannot completely eradicate from that land. So that land cannot be used for the cultivation. Then weed damage human and animal health. Some of the weed seed are poisonous for the animal and human health. Mexican poppy, that is Piula dhutra. Then efficiency of man is also affected by the weeds. Weeds are directly responsible for the health problem like allergy, itching, then spreading of diseases. Such a weeds like Parthenium, Ambrosia, that is ragweed, etc., that cause itching, hay fevers, and other debilitating allergies, contribute markedly to chronic human illness and suffering. Sometimes death can be occur from eating poisonous seeds, berries, tubers, or the weed plants. Mexican poppy seeds crushed with mustard seeds may lead to death and blindness to the people if eaten along with oil. These are the effect on human health, and some of the causing harmful effect on animal health, like that in cattle due to the Parthenium contact, there is a loss of hair, markedly depigmentation of skin, development of odomia, ulceration, and development of lesions in the mouth and intestine. Then certain weeds when fed with cattle along with the fodder reduces the acceptability of fodder to the animals. Partharjata as a fodder may cause premature abortion of fetus due to the excess nitrate content in these weeds. Then Lantana camara induces the hypersensitivity to the light in animal. Then toxic seeds of dhatura, that is kala dhutra, or the sorghum halpens, Johnson grass, when eat excess death of the animals. These are the harmful effect causes weed to the animal health. Next is the weed damage the quality of animal produce. Many times the weed in a pasture or in the forage crops imparts undesirable flavor to the milk and meat of animals. The weeds like Parthenium, Puritivum, Inforbia simplex, and Lepidium sativa, when eaten by milch animals, imparts an undesirable smell and bitter taste to the milk. Then disturbances in public places and reduces the aesthetic value. Due to the weed infestation, weeds growing along with the lawn or ornamental plants generally give ugly look and reduces the value of ornamental plants. For example, nut sage, pathri. Infestation of lakes by water hyacinth is another example to recreational these places. These are the harmful effect of weeds. Then some beneficial effects of weed. So the first is weed used for making compost. For the making compost, mostly water hyacinth are used because it's having rich in nutrient content, nitrogen content. When water hyacinth or the aquatic weed is present in abundance in ponds, lakes, drainage ditches, and other water bodies, this weed is very rich in nutrient, particularly nitrogen. Compost prepared from this weed is of high value. This weed can also be used as a mulch in widely spaced crops. For the preparing compost, water hyacinth or the water body is very useful for the nitrogen content. Then next is a weed check, weed and water erosion. Weed are also helpful in checking erosion from the areas which are not under cultivation, that is desert, waste and slopy lands. They serve as a soil binding agents and they form canopy over the earth surface, which is useful in preventing the soil being blown from the winds. Some of the perennial weeds is also useful for protecting the soil from the wind. Next is the weeds are useful for the fodder. Some of the weeds are used for the fodder of for animal. Some species are used as a scarcity fodder under the famine condition. Certain weeds like Haryali, Shevra, Amaranth species are used for the fodder for the animals. Next is the weeds when plug and nutrient. At the time of ploughing, many of the luxuriant leafy weeds, when buried in the soil, act as green manures, increase the humus and nutrients in the soil. The weeds like bauchi, gokhru, contain about 3 to 3.5% of nitrogen on the dry weight basis. Leguminous weeds like shevra, patata, then senji, wild legumes add nitrogen to the soil by fixing the atmospheric nitrogen. Next is weed. Some of the weeds are used as a leafy vegetables. Leafy vegetables like tanduza, then tanduza, amaranthus, sheepy, then kunjru, pathri, are used as a leafy vegetable, serve as a delicious green vegetables. Then some of the weeds have a medicinal value. A large number of weeds have a medicinal properties and are used in the medicine and drug preparation. For example, guma, tumfa is used as a snake in a snake bite, oil of piula dhotra, Arjumon mexicana, useful for against skin disease and causing of itches. Then plant extract of piuli tivan is very useful for the curing pains of ears. Then Tridrax procumbax ikthandi is used to cure the fresh wounds. So in medicinal purposes, weed also useful. Then some weeds are used for the reclamation of alkali soil. Reclamation of alkali soils like piula dhotra is very useful for reclaiming alkali soil, alkali lands. Then some weeds serve as ornamental plants. Number of weeds, very beautiful and attractive flowers due to which they are used for the beautification. Example, Lantana camara, that is ghaneri, is used for the ornamental plants or hedge in a gardens. Some of the weeds are used as a pot herbs like cactus, haryali for lawn preparation, etc. Some weeds have economic importance. The Kunz saccharum spontaneum is used for thatching purpose. The tubers of lavada are used for the preparation of agarbattis, scented stick for burning purpose and aromatic preparation. Certain weeds are used for the aromatic oils, lemongrass, then maca, then brahmi. Then in cottage industry, some weeds are very useful for the preparation of mats as well as ropes. Then for example, Saccharum muncacans, widely used in cottage industries for preparing basket, furniture, curtains, etc. Apart from this, it is also used by poor people for preparing huts for living. Then is used as a source of protein. Leaf protein could be extracted from many weed plants for the human consumption. The certain weeds control nematodes. Crotalaria species, then Parthenium, Calotropis, etc. when incorporated into the soil helps for control of nematodes. Then weeds as a pollution indicator. Some weeds can be used as an indicator of air pollution. For example, wild mustard is extremely sensitive to indicator of ammonia present in the air. Then Jalmukhi, Jalakumbhi or the water hyacinth are very useful in useful for the plant reclamation of industrial influence, as these weeds absorb heavy metals such as mercury, lead, iron, copper, silver, zinc and tin. Then some of the weeds are useful for the religious purpose. For example, Haryali, mostly used in Ganeshostho, then Aghada, Maka and Rui. These are the beneficial effects.